Yes, hi everybody, it's Eugene Mishin with some stories about my past when I was competing in Russia. One of the stories, I would say a lot of people looking for motivation and don't know what to do themselves. Or looking for excuses why he didn't make or she didn't make this goal happen. In 2002, I was getting ready for one of the city shows, St. Petersburg actually. St. Petersburg is the strongest team, and if anybody wins St. Petersburg, basically turn to, of course, Russian national champion or European champion like me, I turn after that, and world champions, the strong team in Russia. And I was having a hard time when I was getting ready for show. One of the days I had abscess, I guess. I did some stuff and I got infection. And I was still training. And of course, it, like, after a couple of days, it got even more worse. I had terrible like fever. And you know, guys, if somebody had abscess, you know what, how it feels like. And my ass basically began like triple S. And I didn't feel good, and like I went in the morning to see doctor, and he said, oh, I guess you're good to go. I'm gonna do surgery on you. He said, I can do tonight, but he said, better switch for tomorrow. And but I said, listen, maybe not, because I said, I have 8 weeks out for the St. Petersburg show, and it will not be enough time. He said, you're probably not competing no more for like at least couple months. I like, shit, what I do? I already have goal I wanna reach, and began champion St. Petersburg, and began overall champion. And actually, I didn't think that I'm gonna compete later after this shows. I'm gonna do nationals, then Euro. But that's how it usually works. You win city show, then you get qualification for nationals, then you go to world or Europe. And I bought it some antibiotics. It was more popular around bodybuilding community who has abscesses. I mean, guys, I called to one guy, him and the guy, his name is Pavel Yashov. Me and him working out together for a while. And he said, this name's bite and take like three, four pills a day should help. I took 3-4 pills, basically it doesn't work. Of course, abscess getting worse. And probably for all day and night, I probably took 40 of them each. Basically, I was full of antibiotics, and I was keeping ice till all night, till 4 in the morning. Then suddenly it came down, 4 in the morning, I even checked clock, and I don't feel no more heat in my ass. I mean, abscess just got froze, and my temperature began almost normal. Wow, that's interesting. And next day I just didn't go to the doctor to do any shots. Surgery. I went to do physiotherapy. I had office not far away from my house, and I just paid nurse there. She gave me office for use for ultrasound, and every for a couple of weeks I was coming there to knock down my abscess, and it helped. Of course, I was training every day, because usually 6 times a week, training twice a day, cardio. And I was having a hard time to do it, because imagine how much infection was in my body, plus antibiotics. I was very weak. But I was keep pushing myself, because I had my goal. Like I told before, a lot of people looking for excuse, looking for motivation. But remember, if you're gonna fail with your goal, that you cannot hold suffering and struggling with what you have and not get ready for show, means you're gonna fail later with your soul, because probably for me, physical pain is basically nothing. You can handle this, but it's hard to live with a soul pain that you failure. And I'm sure it's going to cost a lot of problems later. Because I see a lot of people who fail, they just keep failing life. And of course, looking for excuse for themselves why they didn't do it. But they know reality when they sit in the apartment or room for walls around, they know why they lost it and why they have failures. And time passed, like 8 weeks passed, I got better, working hard, and started to do final cardio. Usually in the past, I never did my cardio, was getting ready for shows with no cardio, only just soon died because I didn't have enough information this time. And every year I just was finding out more stuff, even experimenting myself or get some advices from people who had more experience competing. And that's how I build up my program, training program, and a cycle and a diet. And finally, I got day of competing. And before show, I like, let me go to, because I was already dehydrated enough. I usually cut water like 3-4 days before show slowly. And add some salt diuretics. And I let me do it another pull out water by go to sauna. I spent in sauna maybe 30 minutes and I had maybe like 1.5 hours to go to show. I came to the show. I was mostly ripped guy there, big of course. I gained some nice mass for whole year. I was getting ready for this. And after when I had couple cold outs, I started to feel like I'm pacing out. I basically couldn't see judges no more. And I stopped to see even audience. And don't look stupid, I just sit down on my knee. Usually like all other bodybuilders starting posing routine and night show. And we had a doctor next to judges all the time. His name is Kirill. He took me, Парадовый, took me from stage. We walk out, I couldn't see anything. He just walked me through this. And I said, listen, open the windows because competition was in spring. And spring, especially, actually in Russia, very cold still in St. Petersburg, can be like 10 minus Celsius. And a lot of heat was in this building. It's actually, they make a lot of concerts there, like big concert hall. And I told them to open windows. My mother was there, she has some pneumonia. For a couple of minutes I was like kind of off. Then, of course I won my class and I just couldn't come back to get my medal. And judges were waiting for me, asking if I was still gonna come back for overall, but because it was my goal, I couldn't just let it go. And I got everything myself together and I went to stage. Of course my protein was a little bit messed up and oil was off, but I still do my call out with all these guys and overall, and I got my overall title. And of course after this I got qualification for Russian nationals. There were a lot of also strong guys there and I won. But to be honest, I was more happy that I won my St. Petersburg show because I mean overall, because a lot of years I was fighting there and it was hard to get this title, but this time I won. And that's why I even didn't care much about nationals, that I won nationals, but actually it's a bigger title. And after that I got qualification for Championship of Europe. A lot of people, I guess they're jealous or whatever, they're not sure about themselves, even judges. Like one judge came to me, he's actually homosexual, always like muscular menace. He came to me, Eugene, you know what I'm saying? If you go to nationals, I mean, if you go to champion of Europe, you cannot make it. I just be happy being on stage. I said, listen, fuck this shit. I said, I go, I'm gonna do well. He said, we'll see, we'll see. You know what's happened . I came there a lot, of course, all people from Europe. Actually, Americans don't come there because I guess when they win nationals, they got pro card. Nobody wants to compete, only I know one girl, Colette Nelson. She actually won world, I think in 2005, if I'm not mistaken. She won 2005 or 2004. And she won nationals, she flew the award and she got title. She's actually one woman who ever won award and I mean all this time. And I'm staying in a meeting, then I was weighing a lot of guys, and of course everyone talking about favorite guys, and was one German guy, big, actually probably about my size, but he was taller than me, I guess, and somehow it looked better than I was little but short. I'm 6'2", 6'3", this guy was about 6'5", maybe something like that. And actually when I came to weigh in, I was little bit smooth, I was carbing up like for 2 days, and water was still on the skin, but the day of the show I was ripped. And a big fan of Arnold Schwarzenegger. I follow his old movies and life, career and everything. And I learned a lot from him, especially how he was terminating his competitors. And I got good lesson. I find out the guy, German guy, he was staying in the same hotel as me. I find out on the desk his number, I mean room number. And for all night I was keep calling him. I didn't sleep also, but what I did, it's like start calling from 10 p.m. Because next day of the competition in the morning, we had, I think, at 9 o'clock start. And first call I did at 10, of course, he came, my wife, I said, oh, can I speak to him in German, can I speak to him? He came and I started cursing him in German. Of course, he got angry, he nabbed the phone. 2 hours later, I called him again, and plus was that you cannot unplug the phone because it was go through the, it's like he's not unplugging phone in the room. He can only break it. And I was keep calling him every 2 hours. Then I guess, imagine somebody nervous for compete next day, and me who is calling him every day, I was speaking half Russian, half German, and what's happening that. Probably I finished calling him at 6 in the morning. I was a little bit tired, but I didn't care about this. I felt good physically, it means I carb up good, rested enough. Actually, one motivation was for me that I won St. Petersburg show overall, not even nationals. The next day we came on stage and even the judge told me that be happy just stay on stage, that you will never come to top 6. And here we go, I see myself in top 6 like, wow. I guess I play 6. Then they start to call names and I see like, wow, somebody just got 6. I guess I'm 5th. Then fifth name different, like, wow, I guess I'm 4. Then when they say 4, it's German guy. Like I even step out forward. I look at on the side, holy shit, I couldn't believe it that a German guy plays 4th. And I like, wow, I guess I'm 3rd. No, this another name came out like, wow, I guess I'm 2nd. And here we go, they call my name, I'm 1st. It was kind of, I'm not a so emotional guy, but I got emotional a little bit on stage. They put Russian anthem, Russian flag. It was kind of very nice. The competition actually was in Minsk, Belarus. It was close by Russia. Actually, we brothers. It's like Ukraine, Belarus, and Russia, it's all brothers, it's we together. Same Slavonic DNA. Yeah, that's what my story about people who sometimes looking for excuses to don't do stuff. That's why if you have chance and you know that's what really what you want from your heart, you should work. Otherwise, you'll never have second chance to do it. And time passes and I know a lot of people who always dream about stuff, be champions, but they always never place exactly what they want, like never win, I mean, always play 2nd or 3rd, but they just not 100% what they're doing. It's like some people feel bad to spend money, some people also happy to have extra meal, or afraid to be small on the stage, or people tied to doing cardio, it means something missing and you'll never get champion. But if you're gonna put things together, always win. It's no problem, it's just a matter of time. That's why, no matter what, stay on your goal. No matter what's happened. Even if, like Schwarzenegger say, if somebody gonna bomb in your building or your town, you still have to do your biceps curl no matter what. Kiss. It was huge mission with you guys. Follow me, put some likes, and it was nice to see you. I'm gonna come back with my new stories.